Where is the lost grave of the bloody Countess Elizabeth Báthory? Is it really just lost, or was it disguised? Why was the funeral 3 months after her death? Reportedly, it was because magnates needed time to come. But none of them came, or none of them admitted he participated. Why is the Chronicle of Village Cachtice the only information source? It says the tomb is under the church. What is the biggest secret of the underground at this place? We begin our search for the lost underground and the grave of Elizabeth Báthory in the oldest part of the church, in the Gothic chapel of St. Anthony. The chapel was built here sometime before 1390, when a Gothic church was built in Cachtice on the site of today's Baroque church. For a long time, local Catholics were struggling with Protestants. While majority used the church, a minority had to settle for a much smaller chapel in the neighborhood.
Takže teď vyhodnotíme, co jsme jako viděli.
Podíváme se aspoň v tom zákoně na střelu, o co jde.
We want to make sure if there's a complex of corridors interconnecting underground spaces, or if there are only an isolated spaces, separate tombs.
Co vidíme?
Georadar shows the underground space under the chapel indeed. As we learn in the rectory, it corresponds to a tomb whose existence is known. But is it really just a tomb?
Je tam díra.
Je tam díra, jo. Pod tím...
Po dvou metrech. Dva metry. Po dvou metrech do 3,5 metru. 1,5 metru.
Odsaď. Až podsaď.
Tady ten prostor.
Jo. To znamená, tady je to nehomogenní, tady je to prostě rozsypaný.
The results also correspond to information provided by Miloš Šimončič, who has been searching for underground spaces under the church in recent years.
1,80 m. Možná, že to ještě kousíček sem, jo, jako, protože my jsme z tohohle stupínku, ale my jsme už na tom byli. Tady to skončilo, vidíte, tady je hrobka, jo, tady je.
A more fundamental finding may come from a strange portal walled up under the bridge across the road. According to William Apfel, it may be an access corridor to the secret tomb of Elizabeth Báthory.
Hrob podľa mňa je v podzemí a dá sa k nemu vojsť alebo dostať tým zamurovaným vchodom pod schodmi.
There was a supporting pillar in this place before the bridge was built. There are basically two options what this can be. Either it is really a walled entrance, or it is a measure to support the wall. However, I'm not an engineer, and I cannot judge it at the moment.
Boli také dohady, že čo to tam bolo, taká klemba pod tým mostom, no ja, možno, že ste sa všimli.
The easiest way to measure would be, of course, from the surface, but we don't have antennas long enough. Therefore, we will try to measure horizontally, directly across the wall.
Ještě jdi úplně takhle od kraje, tady. Máme tu štěný ten.
If there's an entrance to a previously uncovered space behind the walled portal, the georadar should show anomalies. The situation is not much easier for us because the traffic is quite heavy and we measure, of course, in the narrowest place of the road. The fate, of course, has a sense of humor, and since the radar work requires communication between the two operators, the loudest cars pass by. The walled portal was built here at the latest during the construction of the bridge, most probably around 1680, when the church was rebuilt in the Baroque style.
dokážeš. By si směl asi, já ti to podržím.
If there is an underground behind the wall, we can almost certainly say there has been no one in it for more than 100 years. No one intervened in the vault portal during the last major survey in 1938.
Je to ono. Jsme to měřili takhle. 5 metrů jsme tam naměřili.
To je dole od silnice.
Je tu tina žádná, či teda či nič?
No, to
teď, to, teď to zapnu.
Ten most tak jako na cestě?
Na silnici, ano, na hlavní na cestě. Cestě. Tak jsme přikládali georadar na tu stěnu.
Je tak. Ano. Tak to na stěnu.
Ano, ano, ano. A tam je takový výklenek, na ten jsem vylezl a přikládali jsme.
The result from the georadar looks very clear.
Tady je prostor.
No jasný, no.
Tady je kaverna jak prase.
Metr a půl, ano. Na... To je minimálně metr, metr a půl.
Za tým oblukom, ano?
1,46 m, 1,46 m ode zdi.
Do zdi, šel byste do zdi, tak 1,46 m do zdi a tam začíná kaverna.
A 2,80 m. 1,40 m, tady je 1,40 m. Tady je 1,40 m.
No takto, 1,40 m to je vlastně kamenné murivo opevnění, zřejmě.
Ano, ale zatím je 1,40 m prostor.
Georadar shot horizontally, facing the wall, from left to right as viewed from the road. The top two red bands with a black band between indicate the thickness of the masonry, which is exactly 140 centimeters. The most interesting thing is between the distance 100 and 280 centimeters. It is almost perfectly regular.
Došli jsme k tomu, že skutečně, jak si báje mluvili pravdu, je velká pravděpodobnost, že se jedná o velkou kavernu, která je po 1,40 m kamenného zdiva, zhruba široká taky 1,40 m. Jelikož jsme neměli hloubkové antény, takže jsme museli použít měření s směru horizontálním, to znamená, měřili jsme dopředu. Potvrdilo nám to tam velkou kavernu, pravidelnou, jo, to znamená, že by to mohla být chodba nebo cokoliv, jo, bylo by potřeba měřit dál a udělat eventuálně průzkumný vrt, jo, nebo eventuálně to otevřít.
If someone expected to uncover several stones and to find a secret entry into the underground, he would be disappointed. The wall is 140 centimeters wide in all places, likely due to the statics of the bridge. If someone was hiding the entrance to the underground, he had a really hard work. But it is very interesting that the anomaly behind the wall is almost perfectly regular.
Já to vidím z větší části pravděpodobně jako lidský výtvor. Jo, to znamená, že může být samozřejmě příroda dokáže spoustu jiných věcí. Ale pro mě je to jednoznačně kaverna, která má naprosto pravidelný tvar. Jo, když se podíváte na snímek, který z georadaru, tak jasně hovoří o tom, že je to pravidelný.
Of course, it may be a coincidence, but we have most likely found a corridor behind the wall at approximately the 5th meter of the measurement. How far the cavity leads to the other side and how high it is could only clarify further measurements and confirm reconnaissance probes with possible static locking. Today we have discovered there's a most likely a 100 centimeters wide and at least 4 meters long space behind the wall, possibly the end of the corridor or a separate space. If it was somehow related to Elizabeth Báthory and trying to hide her tomb, suddenly it makes sense to postpone her funeral for 3 months. It had to take some time to build this place, and it would make sense why her tomb was not discovered. Due to the height of the retaining wall, the floor of this space was at such a great depth that nobody would ever look for it again. But there's another, perhaps even more promising place. The underground of the church itself and the space near the altar, which was reconstructed and backfilled according to the existing probes.
Skutečnost je taká, tu je náhrobná doska, to je vlastně toto, šrafované, to menšie. Toto je obdoba celej tej hrobky, ale nie celej hrobky, to je vlastně, tu sú schody, ktoré vedú do hrobky, ktorá sa nachádza asi tam, v tej časti. Čiže keby sme to namerali, tak zhruba niekde tam je tá spojnica tých kobercov, takže tam sa nachádza tá hrobka Fogáčovcov. Tá je známa, tam aj
boli. Jak je podľa tej hrobky?
Všetky hrobky sú zhruba asi Tak to začínajú 60, nie, 60 cm začínajú klemba pod podlahou a idú do hĺbky 1,5 m, takže 2,20 m, sú spodok.
Ono je dôležité, abych vedel, jaký má tým anténny zásah.
Všetko sú také, maximálne 2,5 m.
Takže není hluboko, ja si myslel, že je to hluboko.
Podľa všetkých hrobiek, ktoré sú tu, sú tak maximálne 2,5 m pod zemou.
To je dosť dôležité vedieť.